الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك ولعظيم سلطانك سبحانك لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته إن شاء الله we're going to continue with what we were doing last night which is reading from a book called لطائف المعارف فيما لمواسم العام من الوظائف لابن رجب الحنبلي رحمه الله ونفعنا الله به وبكم أجمعين. So this book is called The Subtleties of Knowledge Concerning What Each Season of the Year Contains of Religious Duties. So we're reading from the chapter of Ramadan, which is in fact a separate book, over 100 pages in this particular book. So alhamdulillah, everyone was beautifully making the istighfar a little while ago, seeking Allah's forgiveness. So we'll start with that subject, insha'Allah ta'ala. فقال المصنف رحمه الله ونفعنا الله به وبكم أجمعين. So the author says, may Allah have mercy on him and benefit us through him and through you. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا شهر رمضان تكثر أو تكثر فيه الأسباب الغفران. The month of Ramadan, the causes of forgiveness abound. فمن أسباب المغفرة فيه. From the causes of forgiveness during the month, صيامه وقيامه وقيام ليلة القدر فيه كما سبق. So fasting during this month, as the Prophet mentioned sallallahu alayhi wasallam, صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever fasts the month of Ramadan with sincere faith, anticipating a reward, their prior sins will be forgiven. And he mentions standing for worship at night. So this worship, as we mentioned last night, يعني يجتمعوا في رمضان لجهادان. The two jihads in Ramadan. جهاد في النهار وجهاد في الليل. A struggle in the daytime and a struggle at night. The struggle in the daytime is the fasting, and the struggle at night is the worship. So the worship is a part of the struggle of the month of Ramadan. In any case, so standing for worship during the night of power, as has previously been mentioned. So he previously mentioned the hadith we mentioned, and then expounded on it. من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه ومن قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever stands for worship during the nights of Ramadan with sincere faith, anticipating a reward, their prior sins will be forgiven. ومن قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever stands for worship during the night of power with sincere faith, anticipating a reward, their prior sins will be forgiven. So he's mentioned those previously and expounded on him, hence kama sabaq, as has been previously mentioned. Wa minha, from the means leading to forgiveness, taftiru sawam, giving the fasting people something to break their fast with is a means of forgiveness. Wa takhfifu an al mamluk, and lightening the burden of one who is under your employ. So it says a servant, but even if you have an employee these days and you lighten their burden during Ramadan so that they can have the energy and facility to worship Allah, then that's a means of forgiveness. وهما مذكوران في حديث سلمان المرفوع. And these have both been mentioned in the hadith of Salman, which he relates back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. ومنها amongst them الذكر. So ذكر, everyone was making ذكر a few minutes ago. This is a means of forgiveness. وفي حديث مرفوع. So a hadith that's related back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. ذاكر الله في رمضان مغفور له. The one who remembers Allah in Ramadan will be forgiven. وَمِنْهَا from the causes of forgiveness in Ramadan, istighfar, seeking Allah's forgiveness. So previously you were all seeking Allah's forgiveness. Astaghfirullah. I seek Allah's forgiveness. This is a means to forgiveness. وَالِاسْتِغْفَارُ طَلَبُ الْمَغْفِرَةِ Istighfar is to seek forgiveness. وَدُعَاءَ الصَّائِمِ يُسْتَجَابُ فِي صِيَامِهِ وَعِنْدَ فِتْرِهِ And the prayer of the fasting person is answered during the time that he or she is fasting and at the time that he or she breaks their fast. So when you break your fast, you should make dua. Make dua for yourself, for your family, for your ummah, for the Muslims who are suffering, for the Muslims who aren't suffering, that Allah continues to protect them. As Ibn Abbas mentioned, there are two great blessings Allah reminds us of in the Quran. الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ The one who's fed them and driven off hunger from them and has made them secure from fear. So the blessing of having adequate food and the blessing of safety and security, these are two huge blessings. So we should ask Allah at the time that we break our fast that He continues to protect us. Look at Syria. When we were there, it was unimaginable that the fitna that's there now would afflict that country. There was so much stability and there was so much internal harmony. And just as Allah can turn the hearts, and that's why we ask Allah to protect our hearts. Ya muqallib al-qulub. ثَبِّتْ قَلْبِ عَلَى دِينِكِ This is one of the prayers the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam repeated more than any other. Allahumma ya muqallib al-qulub ثَبِّتْ قَلْبِ عَلَى دِينِكِ ثَبِّتْ قَلْبِ عَلَى دِينِكِ ثَبِّتْ قَلْبِ عَلَى دِينِكِ The one who turns the heart, confirm my heart in your faith and in this religion. And Allah can turn societies. So we have to seek Allah's protection. You know, look at this person who's running for president. Now, who he goes to Jerusalem and he makes these racist, idiotic statements. Who's financing his campaign? The likes of this Edelman guy, hardcore Zionist billionaire. Who is his Islamic advisors? Waleed Faris and Daniel Pipes. Those are the Islamic advisors of a man who could be president of the United States. So we have to pray to Allah that Allah protects us. This safety we enjoy could be taken just like that. So pray at the time you break your prayer. Pray while you're fasting. These are times that the prayer is answered. He says, Allahumma salli ala Rasulillah. ودعاء الصائم يستجاب في صيامه وعند فطره ولهذا كان ابن عمر إذا أفطر يقول اللهم يا واسع المغفرة اغفر لي So he said, consistent with this, Ibn Umar, when he would break his fast, he would say, Oh Allah, the one most expansive in His forgiveness, forgive me. اللهم يا واسع المغفرة اغفر لي Allahumma ya wasi' al-maghfira ighfirli. Allahumma ya wasi' al-maghfira ighfirli. So we should say this dua. Allahumma ya wasi' al-maghfira ighfirli. Allahumma ya wasi' al-maghfira ighfirli. Allahumma ya wasi' al-maghfira ighfirli. Allah, the one most expansive in His forgiveness, forgive me. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. وفي حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه المرفوع في فضل شهر رمضان ويغفر فيه إلا لمن أبى قالوا ومن يا أبا هريرة ومن يأبى قال من يأبى أن يستغفر الله. So it's related on the hadith, in a hadith from Abi Huraira radiallahu anhu, that he relates back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam concerning the virtue of the month of Ramadan. He says, everyone will be forgiven during this month except one who refuses. They said, oh Abi Huraira, who would ever refuse? He said, one who refuses to ask Allah for forgiveness. La ilaha illallah. Let's take a moment to ask Allah for forgiveness. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, tasliman kathira. Astaghfirullah al-Azim al-Ladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-Hayyu al-Qayyum wa atubu ilayhi. Thumma qala rahimahullah wa nafa'ana Allah bihi wa bikum ajma'in. Wa minha istighfar al-mala'ikati lis-sa'imin hatta yuftiru wa qad taqaddama dhikru. And amongst the means or causes of forgiveness during the month of Ramadan are the angels seeking forgiveness for the fasting person until they break their fast. So as you're going through your day of fasting, don't think how hot it is, don't think how long the day is. Think that the entire duration of your fast, the angels are seeking forgiveness for you. That's motivation to keep fasting. There's more forgiveness from the angels. So, oh, it's so hot. Oh, it's so long. Oh, 6 o'clock, 2 more hours. Don't think, oh, the angels are seeking forgiveness for me. How many angels? Subhanallah. La ilaha illallah. How many angels? Subhanallah. La ilaha illallah. Seeking forgiveness for the fasting person until they break their fast. La ilaha illallah. And he's mentioned the hadith that conveys this meaning previously. فَلَمَّا كَثُرَتْ أَسْبَابُ الْمَغْفِرَةِ فِي رَمَضَانَ كَانَ الَّذِي تَفُوتُهُ الْمَغْفِرَةُ فِيهِ مَحْرُومًا غَيَّةَ الْحِرْمَانِ. In that the causes of forgiveness during the month of Ramadan are so abundant, the one who misses the opportunity to be forgiven during the month has been deprived the epitome of deprivation. All of these means, there are more. This is just a sampling that we mentioned. So one who goes from this month and isn't forgiven has been deprived, as he said, غايت الحرمان, the epitome of deprivation. There's no deprivation after that deprivation. May Allah spare us. وفي صحيح ابن وفي Sahih Ibn Hibban. In the Sahih of Ibn Hibban, عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم صعد المنبر فقال آمين 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 قيل يا رسول الله إنك صعدت المنبر فقلت آمين 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 قال إن جبريل أتاني فقال من أدرك شهر رمضان فلم يغفر له فدخل النار فأبعده الله قل آمين فقلت آمين ومن أدرك أبويه أو أحدهما فلم يبرهما فمات فدخل النار فأبعده الله قل آمين فقلت آمين ومن ذكرت عنده فلم يصلي عليك فمن ذكرت عنده فلم يصلي عليك فمات فدخل النار فدخل النار فأبعده الله قل آمين فقلت آمين وخرجه الإمام أحمد إمام أحمد والترمذي وابن حبان أيضا من وجه آخر عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه مرفوعا بلف رغم أنفه وحسنه الترمذي. So in the Sahih of Ibn Hibban, his collection of hadith, on the authority of Abi Hurairah, may Allah be pleased with him, he said that the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, ascended the minbar, and then he said three times, Ameen, 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 O Allah answer, O Allah answer, O Allah answer this prayer. This is the meaning of Ameen, Allahumma istajib. So it was said, O Messenger of Allah, verily you ascended the minbar, and you said, Ameen, Ameen, Ameen. Three times. He said, verily Jibreel came to me and he said, whoever attains to the month of Ramadan and is not forgiven during the month, then let him enter the hellfire and be distanced from the distance from Allah. Say Ameen. So I said Ameen. And whoever one of his parents or his two parents or both of his parents survive and there are not a source of goodness for him, or he does not treat them righteously, and then he dies, let him enter the hellfire and be distanced from Allah. Say Ameen. And I said Ameen. And he said, whoever you are mentioned in their presence, and they do not pray for peace and blessings for you, then they die, let them enter the hellfire and be distanced from Allah. Say Ameen. And I said Ameen. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barak ala Sayyidina Muhammad وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا صلوا على رسول الله اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما حتى تنالوا الجنة ونعيما الله يجزي من يصلي مرة عشرا ويسكن في الجنان مقيما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه صلوا على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. So then he mentions another version of the hadith, slightly different wording. وقال سعيد عن قتادة كان يقال من لم يغفر له في رمضان فلن يغفر له فيما سواه. So it's related from Sa'id. Sa'id used to say on the authority of Qatada that it used to be said, whoever is not forgiven during the month of Ramadan, they will never be forgiven at any other time. How could it be? All of the means and the causes and the gates and the doors of forgiveness are flung open in Ramadan that are shut at other times. So if a person isn't forgiven in Ramadan, when is he or she going to be forgiven? وفي حديث آخر إذا لم يغفر له في رمضان فمتى يغفر لمن لا يغفر له في هذا الشهر. And another hadith, it's related, whoever is not forgiven during the month of Ramadan, when will they be forgiven if they're not forgiven during this month? And then Ibn Rajabi says, مَتَى يَقَبَلُ مَنْ رُدَّ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. When will one ever be accepted if he's rejected during Laylatul Qadr? Or we could say, when will the acts or deeds of a person be accepted if they're rejected during Laylatul Qadr? مَتَى يَصْلُحُ مَنْ لَا يَصْلُحُ فِي رَمَضَانِ. When will one be appropriate and suitable to be forgiven if they're not suitable for forgiveness during Ramadan? مَتَى يَصِحُ مَنْ كَانَ بِهِ فِيهِ مِنْ دَاءِ الْجَهَالَةِ وَالْغَفْلَةِ مَرَضًا. He said, when will one ever be healthy if they're afflicted by the two diseases of ignorance and heedlessness during Ramadan? Heedlessness, people are watching television. People spent the last 2 weeks watching the Olympics, ran home after 8 rakats in the masjid they could find with the quickest recitation. غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين ألف لام ميم الله أكبر غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين ذلك الكتاب الله أكبر غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين لا ريب فيه الله أكبر. Abrakas, run home, watch it. Yeah, USA, USA. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. This is Ramadan, subhanallah. This is Ramadan. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. This is the month the Quran was revealed. من لوح المحفوظ إلى بيت العزة. And then from there to the Prophet ﷺ over 23 years. This is the month of Quran. This is the month of forgiveness. This is the month of mercy. This is the month of Qiyam. This is the month of worship. This is the month of these blessed nights. Look how merciful Allah Ta'ala is. The day is so hot and the night is cool. Allahu Akbar. This is a month of mercy. So he says, Rahimahullah, wa nafa'ala Allah bihi wa bikum ajma'in. Mata yasihu man kana bihi fihi min da'i al-jahalati wa al-ghafla maradan. Kullu ma la yuthmiru min al-ashjari fi awan al-thimar fa innahu yuqta'u thumma yuqadu fi al-nar. He said, every tree that doesn't bear its fruit during the time of harvest, so it dries up and is fruitless, is plucked out of the ground and then thrown into a bonfire. This is the month for the fruit. If there's no fruit because we're watching the Olympics and watching television and gossiping on the phone and spending our nights in heedlessness, there's no fruit. Hashalillah, that we're not like the tree that's just thrown into fire. مَنْ فَطَّرَ فِي زَرْعِي فِي وَقْتِ الْبِذَارِ لَمْ يَحْسُدْ يَوْمَ الْحَصَادِ غَيْرَ النَّدَمِ وَالْخَسَارِ. The one who falls short during the time of planting the seeds, the one who falls short in sowing during the season of planting, he will only reap on the day of harvest regret and loss. May Allah have mercy on us. ثم قال شهر رمضان شهر أوله رحمة وعوسطه مغفرة وآخره عتقم من النار. The month of Ramadan, its first part is mercy, its middle part is forgiveness, its ending is liberation from the hellfire. روي هذا عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث سلمان الفارسي. So this has been related in a hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the authority of Salman al-Farisi. Kharajahu ibn Khuzaymah fi sahih. It's been related by Ibn Khuzaymah in his sahih. Ruwiya anhu ayda min hadith Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu. Kharajahu ibn Abi Dunya wa ghayru. So it's also been related on the authority of Abi Huraira from Ibn Abi Dunya and others. Wa shahru kulluhu shahru rahma wal maghfira wa itqin. Wa lihadha fi al-hadith as-sahih annahu tuftahu fihi abwab ar-rahma. And he says, rather the entire month is mercy, and the entire month is forgiveness, and the entire month is liberation from the hellfire. As it's been related in a sound hadith, that during the month of Ramadan, the gates of mercy have been flung open. So mercy is available during the entire month. وَشَهْرُ وَفِي التِّرْمِذِي وَغَيْرِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ إِنَّ لِلَّهِ أُتَقَاءَ مِنَ النَّارِ وَذَلِكَ فِي كُلِّ لَيْلَةٍ. And is related by Imam al-Tirmidhi and others from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Verily, Allah has those He liberates from the hellfire every night during Ramadan. So the entire night is itq min al-nari, and the entire night is maghfira, and the entire night is mercy. Allahumma sara. ولكن الأغلب في أوله الرحمة وهي للمحسنين المتقين. But mercy predominates during the first part, just as forgiveness predominates during the middle part, and liberation from the hellfire predominates during the latter part. He says, as for mercy, this is for those who do good in their religion and those who are conscious of Allah, and that consciousness translates into implementing His orders and avoiding His prohibitions. قال الله تعالى إن رحمة الله قريب من المحسنين. Allah says in the Quran, verily the mercy of Allah is very close to those who do good and excellent in their religion. قال الله تعالى, and Allah says, be He exalted, ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء فسأكتبها للذين يتقون ويؤتون الزكاة. My mercy extends over everything. I have ordained it. I will ordain it for those who are conscious of my commandments and prohibitions, the muttaqin, and those who diligently pay their zakat. And so this is an indication of the proliferation of Allah Ta'ala's mercy during Ramadan, because He says, فَسَأَكْتُوبُهَا لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ وَيُتُونَ الزَّكَاةِ. What is the essence? What is the great, one of the great goals of Ramadan? يقول الله عز وجل في كتاب العزيز يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. So taqwa is one of the great goals of Ramadan. So I've ordained fasting for you as I ordained it for those who preceded you, in order that you grow in your taqwa. And so the fasting enhances our taqwa, and the taqwa invites the mercy of Allah. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ فَسَأَكْتُوبُهَا لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ. My mercy, I will ordain it for those who have taqwa. And then Ramadan is the month of generosity and spending. كان رسول الله كما قال ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود الناس وأجود ما يكون في رمضان حين يلقاه جبريل فيدارسه القرآن. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was the most generous of people, and the time he was especially generous was Ramadan, when Jibreel would come to him and review the Quran with him. And so Ramadan is the time people like to pay their zakat, and it's the time people are especially charitable. And the mercy of Allah are for those yutuna zakat, those who pay their zakat. So the mercy of Allah is, this is an indication of its abounding in Ramadan. فَيُفَاضُ عَلَى الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي أَوَّلِ الشَّهْرِ كَلَعُ الرَّحْمَةِ وَالرِّدْوَانِ. And so the cloak of Allah's mercy and His pleasure spreads over the people of taqwa during the beginning of Ramadan. وَيُعَامَلُوا أَهْلُ الْإِحْسَانِ بِالْفَضْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ. And the people of good, they're treated with grace and goodness. أَمَّا أَوْسَطُ الشَّهْرِ فَالْأَغْلَبُ عَلَيْهِ الْمَغْفِرَةِ. As for the middle part of the month, mercy forgiveness predominates. وَإِنْ ارْتَكَبُوا بَعْدَ الذُّنُوبِ الصَّغَائِرِ بَعْدَ الذُّنُوبِ الصَّغَائِرَ فَلَا يَمْنَعُهُمْ ذَلِكَ مِنَ الْمَغْفِرَةِ. And so during these days, forgiveness predominates for the fasting people, even those who have perpetrated some minor sins. That does not prevent them from being forgiven. كما قال الله تعالى وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَذُو مَغْفِرَةٍ لِلنَّاسِ عَلَى ظُلْمِهِمْ. And as Allah mentions in the Quran, verily your Lord is the one who possesses forgiveness for people in spite of their oppression. So in spite of their sins. وَأَمَّا آخر الشهر فَيُعْتَقُ فِيهِ مَنَ النَّارِ مَنْ أَوْبَقَتْهُ الْأَوْزَاعُ فَيَسْتَوْجَبَ النَّارِ بِالذُّنُوبِ الْكِبَارِ. And as for the end of the month, liberation from the hellfire predominates, and this is for the people who have been, who would ordinarily have been ruined because of their sins, and they deserve to be punished in the hellfire of hell because of their major transgressions. وَفِي حَدِيثِ ابْنِ عَبَّاسٍ الْمَرْفُوعِ. And it's related by Ibn Abbas, hadith related by Ibn Abbas. لِلَّهِ فِي كُلِّ لَيْلَةٍ فِي شَهْرِ رَمَضَانِ عِنْدَ الْإِفْطَارِ أَلْفُ أَلْفِ أَتْعَتِيقٍ مِنَ النَّارِ فَإِذَا كَانَ لَيْلَةُ الْجُمُعَةِ أَوْ يَوْمُ الْجُمُعَةِ عَتَقَ فِي كُلِّ سَاعَةٍ فِيهَا أَلْفَ أَلْفِ عَتِيقٍ مِنَ النَّارِ كُلُّهُمْ قَدْ اسْتَوْجَبُوا الْعَذَابِ فَإِذَا كَانَ آخر ليلة آخر ليلة من رمضان من شهر رمضان أعتق الله في ذلك اليوم بعدد ما أعتق من أول الشهر إلى آخره خرجه سلمة بن شبيب وغيره. لا إله إلا الله. قولوا لا إله إلا الله. Say لا إله إلا الله. Say لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله. So this hadith of Ibn Abbas, which he relates back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Verily, Allah has every night in Ramadan, at the time of iftar, 1 million people that He liberates from the hellfire. And then, when the day of the night of Jumu'ah or the day of Jumu'ah comes, He liberates. During every moment, we could say sa'ah as a moment, 1 million people from the hellfire, all of them are deserving to be punished therein. And then when the last night of the month of Ramadan comes, Allah liberates from the hellfire the number that He's liberated from the beginning of the month to the end of the month. La ilaha illallah. And He said all of them, kulluhum. قَدِسْتَوْجِبُ الْعَذَابِ. All of them deserve to be punished because of their sins. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. This is Allah subhanahu. This is Allah, the stern, unforgiving God of the Muslims. And this is your refutation of those empty, ignorant claims. Ramadan is your hujjah over anyone who claims that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lacks mercy and lacks forgiveness and lacks concern for His servants. This is your proof. Ramadan is your proof. La ilaha illallah. So this hadith is related by Salama bin Shabib and others. وإنما كان يوم الفطر من رمضان عيدا لجميع الأمة لأنه يعتق فيه أهل الكبائر من الصائمين من النار. And he says rather Eid al-Fitr at the end of Ramadan is a festive day for the entire Ummah, because during that day Allah liberates the people who have perpetrated the major sins from the fasting people from the hellfire. فَيَلْتَحِقُ فِيهِ الْمُذْنِبُونَ بِالْأَبْرَارِ. And during that day, those sinners join the ranks and get the privilege of forgiveness that's extended to the righteous. كَمَا أَنَّ يَوْمَ النَّحْرِ هُوَ الْعِيدُ الْأَكْبَرُ. Just as the day of sacrifice is the great Eid. لِأَنَّ قَبْلَهُ يَوْمَ عَرَفَةَ. Because it's preceded by the day of Arafah. وَهُوَ الْيَوْمُ الَّذِي لَا يُرَى فِي يَوْمٍ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا أَكْثَرُ عِتْقًا مِنَ النَّارِ مِنْ. Because it's the day, there's no day in the days of this world that more people are liberated from the hellfire than on the day of Arafah. فَمَنْ عُتَقَ مِنَ النَّارِ فِي فَلَهُ يَوْمُ عِيدٍ. And the one who's liberated from the hellfire on these 2 days has a yawm of a day of celebration. وَمَنْ فَاتَهُ الْإِتْقُ فِي الْيَوْمَيْنِ فَلَهُ يَوْمُ وَعِيدٍ. And whoever fails to be liberated during these 2 days, he has a day where the threat of Allah's anger is facing him. Alhamdulillah. كما كانت المغفرة والإتق من النار كل منهما مرتبا على صيام رمضان وقيامه أمر الله سبحانه وتعالى عند إكمال العدة بتكبيره وشكره فقال ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون. He says that forgiveness and liberation from the hellfire, both of these are contingent upon fasting the month and standing its nights in prayer. Allah Ta'ala has ordered the servant that he completes the designated period. وَلِتُكْمِلُ الْعِدَّةَ. So to complete the worship of the month, not the first week, everyone has a lot of himma and enthusiasm. And then the second week, you know, they start ducking out after 8 rakats. And then the third week, they don't even come anymore. And then the fourth week, they start getting ready for Eid. They make phone calls. Did they see the moon? Did they see the moon? Like, hurry up and get done with it. La ilaha illallah. Allahu musta'an. وَلِتُكْمِلُ الْعِدَّةَ. That you complete the period of 29 or 30 days. مَنْ قَامَ رَمَضَان. لَيْسَ مَنْ قَامَ أسبوع الأول من رمضان من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever stands for worship the whole of the month and whoever fasts the whole of the month, ولتكمل العدة, to complete the period, وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ, and that you extol the greatness of Allah for guiding you to complete the period. وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, in order that you will give thanks. That's why the Eid is a day of shukr. Thanking Allah that He blessed us to complete the period. Thanking Allah that He's guided us to be able to have the privilege and the honor of extolling His greatness and blessing us with the means to give Allah thanks and something to thank Allah for. فَشُكْرُ مَنْ أَنْعَمَ عَلَىٰ عِبَادِهِ بِتَوْفِيقِهِ لِلصِّيَامِ. This is what we said. The thankfulness is from the one who has given his servants the facilitation to undertake the fast. وَإِعَانَتِهِمْ عَلَيْهِ, and has helped them to complete it and assisted them by giving us something to have breakfast with in the morning, giving us something to make iftar with, so we can continue fasting with vigor, so we can have the strength to pray at night. Think we fasted all day and there's no clean water to drink. There's no food to eat and replenish our bodies. How difficult would it be to be here right now? One in the morning. Still going strong. Allahu Akbar. It would be difficult, but Allah has assisted us and aided us and given us the wherewithal to nurture and nourish our bodies so we could be here right now and we could keep fasting and we can keep praying and we can keep extolling the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ilaha illallah. وَمَغْفِرَتِهِ لَهُمْ بِهِ, and for his forgiving them during the month, wa itqihim min an-nar, and his liberating them from the hellfire. This is why we thank Allah, wa la'allakum tashkurun. Wa la'allakum tashkurun. This is why we thank Allah. And yadhkuruhu wa yashkuruhu wa yattaquhu haqqa tuqatih. And that you remember him and thank him and be mindful of him as should rightfully be the case. وَقَدْ فَسَّرَ ابْنُ مَسْعُودٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ تَقْوَاهُ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ بِأَنْ يُطَاعَ فَلَا يُعْصَى وَيُذْكَرَ فَلَا يُنْسَى وَيُشْكَرَ فَلَا يُكْفَرَ. And Ibn Mas'ud has explained being mindful of Allah as should rightfully be the case, that he is obeyed and he's not rebelled against, that he is remembered and that he's not forgotten, that he's given, he's thanked, and his blessings are not taken for granted. This is haqqa tuqatihi. So we should commit ourselves to being the people of obedience. We should commit ourselves that we will strive with might and main to never disobey Allah as long as we need, as long as we live. If we slip and fall short, we'll renew that commitment, inshallah. Wa'atum, inshallah. Oh Allah, we commit ourselves that we'll be the people of obedience and we'll never rebel against you. As long as you keep us alive in this world, with your help and your assistance, Ya Allah, assist us to fulfill what we're convening. And yuta'a fala yu'asa. And may Allah bless us to be the people of shukr. And yushkar fala yukfar. May Allah bless us to be the people of shukr. May Allah bless us to be the people of dhikr and yudhkara fala yunsa. Subhanallah. If someone gave you $1 million, you never forget them. Would you? They just met you on the street. Ya fulan. Ahna wa sahna. Inni uhibbuka fillah. Fa khudh million dollar. You'd never forget that, people. Wa ismi Ahmed. You'd never forget Ahmed. You pray for Ahmed every night. Ya Allah, bless Ahmed. You never forget Ahmed. Subhanallah, what Allah Ta'ala has given to you for more valuable, $100 million. How could we ever forget Allah? How much is your eyesight worth? If you lost your eyesight and you had $100 million and the doctor said, I think I could fix your vision, I think I could get you seeing, but it's gonna cost you $100 million. Are you going to hold on to your money or are you going to get your sight back? How much is your taste worth? If you ate your food and you couldn't taste it anymore, and the doctor said, you know, I could restore your taste, it's going to cost you $1 million. You part with $1 million. If you lost your hearing, I could get it for you back, but the operation is going to cost $1 million. You part with $1 million. And you never forget that doctor. MashaAllah. That's the greatest specialist on earth. I went to so many doctors, no one could help me. And that doctor got my sight back. MashaAllah. You never forget him. How can we forget Allah who gave us the sight and perpetuates it? How can we forget Allah who's given us this hearing and perpetuates it? How can we forget Allah who's given us our taste, giving us our ability to feel? Think how we could harm ourselves if we couldn't feel. Our hand is burning, we don't even know it till we smell it. Oh boy. Because we can't feel anything. Then our hand is burned up. Allah has blessed us. فَأَسْبَغَ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعَمَهُ ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنَا. He's extended his blessings over you. أَسْبَغَ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعَمَهُ. In open and hidden ways. In open and hidden ways. Man, Allah. How can we forget Allah? He says, you remember Allah. And remember Allah. all these blessings. People, this is the Ramadan of complaints. So many people calling, complaining, emailing, complaining. They have their health, they have their wealth, they have their children, they have their spouses, they have their houses, they have food in the fridge. But they're complaining. Oh, woe is me. Subhanallah. Where is your love for Allah? Where is your connection to Allah? Where is your appreciation for the blessings Allah has given you? The people should be complaining, they're not complaining. You go to Gaza right now in Ramadan, and people are praying and fasting under the eye of drones flying over that can unleash the kind of hell that was unleashed on the people of Gaza a few years ago in Operation Cast Lead. Are they complaining? Any Palestinians in the house? Palestinians. People complaining in Gaza? No. They're not complaining. They're thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't have the food you have. They don't have the house you have. They don't have the security you have. They can't get married as easy as you can get married. They have to wait till they're 40 years old, right? The Shabab, drive a taxi in Gaza, saving up his, they unfortunately they have to save up their shekels for 20 years to get married. You get out of college, you don't even graduate college. You get married your junior year in college. And you're complaining. Where is Allah? Where is the remembrance of Allah? If you remember Allah and remember the blessings and bounties and grace and mercy and forgiveness and liberation of Allah Ta'ala, there'd be no room in your heart for complaining. No room in your heart for complaining. La ilaha illallah. And yuta'a. Fala yu'asa. And yuzkara. Fala yunsa. وَأَنْ يُشْكَرَ فَلَا يُكْفَرَ. That he's thanked for his blessings and he's not, the blessings aren't rejected. And what if we thank Allah, find the wherewithal to thank Allah, وَلَأَنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. Allah said, I will give you more. All you have to do is thank me. All you have to do is thank me. لا إله إلا الله. Man, Allah. Faya arbab al-dhunub al-azima, al-ghanimata al-ghanimata fi hadhihi al-ayyam al-kareema, fama minha iwadun wa la laha qima. He says, oh, you possessors of great sins, take the bounty of these noble days. And these days, they have no substitute, and no other days have their values. Their value. فَمَا مِنْهَا عِوَضٌ وَلَا لَهَا قِيمَةٌ. You won't find days like this. Brothers and sisters, take advantage of these days. Once it's gone, it's not coming back. Maybe we'll have next Ramadan, but next Ramadan is not this Ramadan. Once this Ramadan is gone, once these days are gone, they're never coming back. Maybe we'll have next Ramadan. Maybe not. Next year is not promised to any of us. Take advantage now. Get the harvest now. Get the ghanima now. Get the booty now. Because next year, we might not be around to have the opportunity. Wallahu al-musta'an. والله المستعان نعم فيا أرباب الذنوب العظيمة الغنيمة الغنيمة في هذه الأيام الكريمة فما منها عوض ولا لها قيمة فكم يعتق فيها من النار من ذي جريرة وجريمة. How many people are liberated from the hellfire and they're from the people of sin and crime. Crimes against Allah and against their soul. فَمَنْ عُتَقَ فِيهَا مِنَ النَّارِ فَقَدْ فَازَ بِالْجَائِزَةِ الْعَمِيمَةِ. وَالْمَنْحَةَ الْجَسِيمَةِ Whoever is liberated from the hellfire, they've gotten the all-encompassing prize, and they've gotten the hugest gift. To translate jasima, huge. Say هذا الأخ جسيم, like it's huge. But هذا المنحة الجسيمة, this is a great, great, huge gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يا من عتقه مولاه من النار إياك أن تعود بعد أن سرت حرا إلى رق الأوزار. He says, oh, the one who's been liberated by his Lord from the hellfire, beware of all costs that you return after you've been made free to the slavery of sin. Sin is slavery. And living a life free of sin is liberation. May Allah liberate us, all of us. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. So he goes on. It's late. Allah yubarik fikum. Allah yataqabbal minkum. Zadakum Allahu fi kulli khair. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى لكم ولنا وللمسلمين جميعا التوفيق والعافية. نسأل الله تعالى لنا ولكم وللمسلمين جميعا الإتقاء من النار. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى لنا ولكم وللمسلمين جميعا المغفرة في هذا الشهر. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى لنا ولكم وللمسلمين جميعا الفوز بالجنة وصحبة الأبرار. ونسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى جنة الفردوس الأعلى مع زمرة النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. الله يبارك فيكم. One of the وظيفة, in addition to the عفو, asking Allah for pardon, also is the kalimat al-tawheed during these days. So we ask Allah Ta'ala that He blesses us to repeat abundantly La ilaha illallah. The Hamdul Qari Omar took you through the whole, the guided tour. Istighfar, tahleel, al-afu, wa tasbih, kalimatani خفيفتان على اللسان ثقيلتان في الميزان حبيبتان إلى الرحمن سبحان الله وبحمده سبحان الله العظيم الحمد لله. So may Allah bless us to continue these good practices. May Allah Ta'ala, we can do a little La ilaha illallah in the context of La ilaha illallah qasira inshaAllah Ta'ala. Then I seek your permission to move on inshallah to other stops and destinations. Allah yubarik fikum. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Muhammad Rasulullah. Alayhi salatullah. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah Alayhi salatullah Biha yathbutul iman Biha yahsulul aman Karir ayyuhal insan La ilaha illallah La ilaha illallah La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah Alayhi salatullah Qad atana fil akhbar عن النبي المختار أن أفضل الأذكار لا إله إلا
Muhammad Rasulullah alayhi salatullah takrahuha ma ahla ma abahu ma ahla tunni al-abda min mawla la ilaha illallah la ilaha حسنك الحصين هي درعك المتين ذكر رب العالمين لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول ذاكروها لا يشقى لا ينال فرقا هي عروة الوثقى لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله عليه صلاة الله لازموها يا إخوان نوروا بها الجنان إن مفتاح الجنان لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله عليه صلاة الله لازموها بالأسحار والعشي والإبكار تستمده من أنوار لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله عليه صلاة الله خير خلقي عند الله صاحب العز والجاه خاتم رسل الإله محمد رسول الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله عليه الصلاة
الفاتحة لنيرة الفرج للمسلمين في كل في شتى أنحاء العالم وعلى وجه الخصوص إخواننا المسلمين وأخواتنا المسلمات بالشام وفي فلسطين والعراق وأفغانستان والباكستان والهند والبنغال وشريلانكا وفي مصر اللهم أزل عنهم الحكم العسكري اللهم أزل عنهم عن الشعب المصري مصري الحكم العسكري اللهم أعطيهم ثمرات ثورتهم يا الله وفي ليبيا وتونس والجزائر والمغرب وفي موريتانيا والسنغال وغامبيا ونيجيريا وفي هذا البلد اللهم انصرنا في هذا البلد اللهم انصرنا في هذا البلد اللهم انصرنا في هذا البلد أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين وعلى نية القبول لما قدمنا في هذا الشهر المبارك وعلى نية الفرج وعلى نية